In this video, we will talk about the mole concept. Okay, mole is actually just a number, like 1 mole is equal to 6.022 × 10²³ particles. These particles can be anything, like it can be ion, atom, or molecule. Okay, so 1 mole is like this, and this number is known as Avogadro number. It is written like this, Na. Okay, and one more thing we would discuss about, like 1 dozen is like 12 atoms. Same like that in the case of atoms, because they are very small, the molecules, atoms, even we cannot see them with the help of microscope as well. So that is why we need a measurement unit like this. So 1 mole means this number, okay, 6.022 × 10²³ particles. Okay, now some terms we should know about, like GAM, GMM, GFM, and AMU. We should know about these terms first. Okay, so like if we talk about the atomic mass first, atomic mass, then that means we are talking about mass of one atom. Okay, like the mass of sodium element, the sodium atom, it would be 23 unit. So what is this? This is the atomic mass. Atomic mass means the mass of one atom. But there are some molar masses, like this gram atomic mass, gram formula, gram molecular mass, gram formula mass, and then atomic mass, that is the unit of this mass. Okay, now gram atomic mass means that the mass of 1 mole atoms in grams, the mass of 1 mole atoms in gram, it would be gram atomic mass. And in the case of GMM, it is gram molecular mass, it would be mass of 1 mole molecules in grams. So 1 mole molecules, it would be in grams, it would be GMM, that is gram molecular mass. Actually these are same, like they are molar masses. Okay, but when we take atoms, 1 mole atoms in gram, then it would be gram atomic mass. And when we talk about the molecules, then mass of 1 mole molecules in gram, it would be gram molecular mass, that is GMM. Same like GFM, GFM is used to the like in the case of ionic compound, like NaCl. We all know that NaCl is a ionic compound, ionic compound, Na plus and Cl negative. Okay, ionic compound, those compounds which are made from the ions. Okay, in the case of sodium chloride, this is sodium ion and this is chloride ion, and when they combined with each other, they form ionic compound, that is NaCl. So in this case, when we take mass of 1 mole ions in grams, then it would be gram formula mass. And now atomic mass unit we would talk about. 1 AMU, it is also written as U, that is unified unit. Generally we write like the mass of carbon atom is 12 U, mass of sodium atom is 23 U. So this is what, this is unified unit, we generally use it. And sometimes we also write it like in the honor of John Dalton, like DA as well. Okay, so 12 Dalton, 13 Dalton, like this. But we generally use this unit, that is unified unit U, that is 1 atomic mass unit. So what is this atomic mass unit? Is actually 1/12 of mass of 1 carbon 12 atom. Why we are taking carbon 12 atom? Because we all know that carbon is having their its isotopes, like carbon 12, carbon 13, carbon 14. Okay, but in the nature it's found in major amount. Carbon 12 is found in major amount, and because we can divide it into 12 equal parts, because we are talking about a standard for atomic masses. Okay, we are talking about a standard for atomic masses, that is why we are using this carbon 12 atom. So let's assume this is the carbon 12 atoms mass like this, and we can divide it into 12 parts, 4, 6, 8 and now 12. So let's assume that these all parts are equal. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 and 12. So let's assume that all parts are equal here, and that is why we can take a single part. Let's assume this is the 12th part we are taking as written here. Okay, it can be any part, but we are taking this part, 12th part. Okay. So because all parts are equal, so this part can be a standard here for the atomic mass unit. So one atomic mass unit is what? It is the 1/12th of the mass of the carbon 12 atom. Okay. Now the thing is, that is, what is the mass of one carbon 12 atom, and what will be its 1/12th part? That will be the one atomic mass unit. So let's calculate it. The 1/12, and we know that when we talk about the mass of an atom, then mass of atom means number of proton plus number of neutrons, because electrons are negligible in mass. So let's assume this is the nucleus of the carbon, and it has protons and neutrons inside it. It's a nucleus, and electrons are revolving around the nucleus in the circular orbits like this. This is the basic structure of atom, like K, L, N, M, N, O, like that. So electrons are in this circular orbits around the nucleus. So because electrons are negligible in mass, so we can take when the mass of one carbon atom, it would be the atomic number of carbon is 12. That means the number of proton is 12. The atomic number of carbon is 6 actually. So the number of proton is same as the atomic number, that is 6 here. Okay. So that means one carbon 12 atom have 6 proton, which is equal to the 6 neutron now. So 6 proton plus 6 neutron, which are present in the nucleus of this atom, and plus 6 electrons. But because electrons are negligible in mass, and we are talking about the atomic mass, okay, so that is why we would talk about the only about the proton and neutron. So it would be 1/12 times, and we know that the mass of proton and neutrons are approximately equal, so we can take it 6 plus 6, 12, and into the mass of proton, okay, the mass of proton. So 12 and 12, it can be like this, we can cut it. So one atomic mass unit will be equal to the mass of proton. With the help of modern devices like mass spectrometer, we know that nowadays the mass of proton is 1.67 times 10 to the power minus 24 gram. So that means we can say that one atomic mass is equal to 1.67 into 10 to the power minus 24 gram, which is the mass of proton as well. Okay. Now let's say that what would be the mass of one carbon atom. So the mass of one carbon atom means number of protons, 6 proton plus 6 neutron. We would not take the number of electron, which is equal to the number of proton, like 6 electron actually. So here we would not take this, because the mass of electrons are negligible. So 6 proton plus 6 neutron, that means 12, and the mass of proton and neutrons is approximately equal, and this is the mass of proton, that is 1.67 into 10 to the power minus 24 gram. Okay, this is the mass of proton. But we know that this number is a standard, that is atomic mass unit, so it would be 12 amu. Okay, so the mass of one carbon atom is 12 amu, or it can be written like 12 u as well. U is what? U is the unified unit. Okay. So because we are talking about the mole, so what would be the mass of 1 mole carbon atom? So let's calculate it. Mass of 1 mole carbon atom. So it would be, when mass of 1 carbon atom is like 12 unit, then the 1 mole carbon atom is like 12 unit multiplied by this number. Okay. So 12 amu, at the place of amu we can write 1.67 in times 10 to the power minus 24, okay, gram. This is what? This is the mass of single carbon atom. Because we are talking about 1 mole carbon atom, so we would multiply it by this number, because 1 mole is 6.022 times 10 to the power 23. So we can multiply it like this, 6.022 times 10 to the power 23. Okay, so when we multiply these two things, then we can get 1, because this is 10 to the power minus 24 and here 10 to the power 23. So we can get 1 gram. So the mass of 1 mole carbon atom would be 12 gram. So 12 gram is what? This is the mass of 1 mole carbon atom. And we already know that when we talk about the mass of 1 mole atom in gram, then it would be gram atomic mass. So that means this is what? This is its gram atomic mass, that is GAM. Okay. So in this video we had discussed about the atomic mass, that is the mass of 1 single atom, gram atomic mass, that is mass of 1 mole atoms in gram, gram molecular mass, that is mass of 1 mole molecules in grams, and gram formula mass in the case of ionic compound, and atomic mass unit, this is the standard which is equal to the 1/12th of the mass of 1 carbon 12 atom. After calculating we can get that 1 atomic mass is equal to the mass of proton, that is 1.67 times 10 to the power minus 24 gram. So that is why if we write like the mass of carbon atom is 12 unit, so it would be 12 into unit means atomic mass unit, it is equal to the 1.6 times 10 to the power minus 24 gram. Okay, like that. So this is what? Gram atomic mass. And we had discussed some things like the mass of 1 mole carbon atom. So in my next video we will talk about the numericals which is based on the mole concept. I think it's clear now. Thank you.